You are God's creature, designed for glory. You are not designed for shame.
Return it back in Jesus' name. I rebuke the devil.
God is a God of mercy. When you understand that God is a God of mercy, you are a creature of intention. God created you intentionally.
Get set for a moment of empowerment with your host, Benjamin Beckley.
Glory be to God. Hallelujah. In blessing, you are blessed. In favor, you are highly favored. As it relates to lifting, you shall experience uncommon lifting in this season in the precious name of Jesus. Welcome to Moment of Empowerment with Benjamin Beckley. And I remain your host, Benjamin Beckley, of the Empowerment Center in Arlington, Texas, USA. Thank you so much for tuning into this broadcast today. I know you shall be greatly blessed of the Lord in the name of Jesus. Now, Moment of Empowerment is a revelational and prophetic broadcast that is dedicated to empower you towards taking your rightful place in destiny. There is a place for you in the program of God. You are not a creature of mistake. You are a creature of intention to manifest gloriously and mightily on the earth. That's why the Bible says you are wonderfully and fearfully made. You are full of wonders to manifest on the earth. So your place on the earth is a place of wonder and not to be wandering. It's a place of lifting and not a place of being defeated. And that's why you need to be empowered in order for you to take your rightful place in the program of God for your life. I know definitely that in the name of Jesus, by the reason of today's broadcast, something new will happen to you. A shift will take place in your atmosphere. Your eyes of understanding be opened afresh in the precious name of Jesus. Once more, thank you for tuning into this broadcast today. I appreciate all your calls. Thank you for all your messages. Thank you for the prayers as well as the support. It goes a long way to encourage us as well as to enhance the advancement of the kingdom of God. The Lord bless you. The Lord keep you in the precious name of Jesus. Now, I'd like you to do me a favor. I want you to call somebody you know anywhere that needs encouragement. Someone you know needs to be motivated. Someone you know is downcasted and needs to be lifted. Anyone you know somewhere that is passing through such times as we are, difficulties and toughness, but you know that they need solution. Someone you know anywhere that things are not working for, but you desire to have them blessed of the Lord. Tell them the station you are watching me right now. Let them connect. Send a message to them. Call them on the phone. Get your children together with you, because God surely has a word for you. He has a word for your family. One word from God can turn your world around for better. One word from God can turn your world around for better. It is time to be empowered, and God's word is our primary channel for connecting with power. I know today that whatever be the situation, God's word will bring solution in the name of Jesus. Things will no longer remain the same for you. There will be a supernatural change of circumstances and story in your direction in the precious name of Jesus. Now, right before we go into God's word today, I'd like to invite you to any of our services at the Empowerment Center. I want you to understand that for you to be the best in life, you need a place where you can be nurtured with the undiluted word of God. You need a place where you can connect with the flow of God's power. You need a place where you can experience the genuine love of God. And I can tell you, the Empowerment Center is the right place to be. The Empowerment Center is a non-denominational, multicultural, word-based church of God that is on assignment of empowering lives towards fulfilling destiny. Join us in any of our services. The information is right on the screen. We hold our services on Thursdays, 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. We have empowerment service. And on Sundays, 10 a.m. to 12 noon, you shall surely be blessed in any of the services as you connect. The address is on the screen. Call the number if you need direction or even if you need prayers. We are here for you to ensure that you be all that God wants you to be enjoy all that God wants you to enjoy, and at the end, have major impact in your world as a personality. The Lord bless you as you come. I look forward to having you this Sunday. I look forward to receiving you. Let's come together, celebrate the faithfulness of God. And I can tell you, you will never remain the same as you connect with God in the precious name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Now, in case you are just tuning in to this broadcast today, this is still Moment of Empowerment with Benjamin Beckley. And I am your host, Benjamin Beckley of the Empowerment Center. Now, today, by the grace of God, I shall be starting a new series of teaching, which I have entitled, Make a Move. The title I'm going to be considering today is entitled, Make a Move. Listen to me. Until you move, nothing moves. Until you move, nothing moves. Everyone that desires to see things move for them must be ready to make a move. If you don't make a move, nothing moves around you. Things may move around, but nothing moves in you. Nothing moves you. If you are not making a move, you will remain the same. You remain in the same spot. Things don't change until there is a change and first. Now, rephrasing one of the Newton's first law of motion that states that everything remains in a perpetual state of rest until there is an external force that is applied. Nothing moves until something moves them. And until you make a move, things remain the same. In Deuteronomy chapter 1, verse 6 to 8, we got an understanding that until you are willing to make a move, then you are not ready to experience a movement. Until you are willing to make a move, you are not ready to experience a movement. In Deuteronomy 1, 6 to 8, the Bible says, "The Lord our God spoke unto us in Horeb, saying, you have dwelt long enough in this mountain. You have been on this mountain enough. You have spent much time in the same thing. You have spent more time doing the same thing over and over again." But look at what God said in verse 7. Because God is interested in your movement. God is interested in your progress. God is interested in your advancement. The Bible says, God said, "Turn ye and take your journey and go to the mount of the Amorites and unto all the places near, thereunto in the plain, in the hills, in the valley, in the south, by the seaside, to the land of the Canaanite, and unto Lebanon, unto the great river, the river Euphrates." Now look at verse 8. "Behold, I have set the land before you." Listen to me. Until you make a move, you cannot be positioned where God has set before you. "I have set the land before you," but you got to move into the land. Until you make a move, you can't move things. Come on now. "I have set the land before you. Go in and possess the land which the Lord swore unto your fathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, to give unto them and to their seed after them." If you are not moving, things will always bypass you. "I have set the land before you, but you got to go into the land to possess it." Somebody is listening to me. You have tarried long on this mountain a long time. You have been in that situation a long time. You've been complaining a long time. You've been postponing a long time. You've been procrastinating a long time. I have come today to tell you about the word of the Lord. It is time to make a move. Therefore, in the name of Jesus, I break the hold of stagnancy over your life. I break the hold of frustration over your life. Everywhere you have been, standing, the same spot, just wishing things changes, but you are not willing to make a move, I decree the Lord will stir up your spirit to make relevant moves in the name of Jesus. Everywhere you have been wandering around, he said, "You have tarried on this mountain long enough. You've been in this place long enough. Everywhere you are overdue, I command a door open for you. Move out from there. Come out from that sickness. Come out from that trouble. Come out from that marital treasure in the precious name of Jesus." Where you supposed not to still be, but you are still there. You are still wandering there. There is no progress. I decree in the name of Jesus, this season will be to you the season to make progress. No more stagnation in the precious name of Jesus. Somebody say amen. Glory to God. You have tarried long enough on this mountain. You've been here. And God said, it's time to make a move. Now, let's connect with some scriptural revelations as we consider this subject matter. We need to look at the scripture than to look at what does the Bible have to say concerning making a move. But you understand from what I've shared with you that God is interested in your progress. It is the devil that is not interested in your progress. But God is interested in your change of story, is interested in your elevation, is interested in the things that things works for you. But until you make a move, the land he has set before you, you may not be able to feature there. Somebody say amen. Now, let's open our Bible to 2 Kings chapter 7. We look at scripture from verse 1 to 8. It's a pretty long scripture, but in it contains the revelation we want to consider as we look at make a move. 2 Kings chapter 7, this is our anchor text for this day, verse 1 to 8. The Bible says, then Elisha said, hear ye the word of the Lord. First said the Lord, tomorrow about this time shall a measure of fine flour be sold for a shekel and 2 measures of barley for a shekel in the gate of Samaria. Verse 2, then the Lord, on whose hand the king leaned, answered the man of God and said, behold, if the Lord will make windows in heaven, I this day. And he said, behold, thou shalt see with your eyes, but you shall not eat of it. Verse 3. And there were 4 leprous men at the entrance of the gate, and they said one to another, why sit here until we die? You will not die. Verse 4. If we say we will enter into the city, then the famine is in the city, and we shall die. If we sit here, we shall die also. Now therefore come, let us fall into the host of the Syrians. If they save us alive, we shall live. And if they kill us, we shall but die. Verse 5. And they rose up in the twilight to go unto the camp of the Syrian. And when they were come to the uttermost part of the camp of the Syrian, there was no man there. For the Lord had made the host of the Syrian to hear a noise of chariots and noise of horses, even the noise of a great host. And they said one to another, lo, the king of Israel had hired against us the kings of the Hittites and the kings of the Egyptians to come upon us. Wherefore, they arose and fled in the twilight and left their tents and their horses, their axes, even their camp as it was, and fled for their lives. Verse 8, and when these lepers came to the uttermost part of the camp, they went into one tent and did eat, they drink, and carried silver, gold, and raiment, and went and eat it. And they came again, entered into another tent, carried nets also, and they went to eat it. Somebody say amen. God bless you. May the Lord bless his word. Now, I'd like you to understand from this scriptural revelation that there are certain insights you need to connect with. On our way to consider making a move, there are some things the Holy Ghost showed me that I want to share with you. Number one thing I saw from this text as we write on is this, that God's word is God's primary channel for enforcing solution to life situations. God's word is God's primary channel for provoking or establishing or activating solutions to life situation. Hear me? Every situation of life has an answer in God's word. When you connect with God's word, your world cannot remain the same. In Psalm 107 verse 20, Bible says, he sent his word, the word healed them and delivered them from all their destructions. So when God's word comes, solution comes. When God's word comes, changes must happen. When God's word comes, there must be a shift. From the scripture, we discovered in verse 1 that God sent his word in order to change the situation that was in place. Right before this chapter, there had been a terrible situation. There was a mighty famine which has besieged Samaria. In 2 Kings chapter 6 from verse 24 to 29, a king came from Syria and he besieged Samaria. He allowed them not to go, so there was great famine in the land. Now the trouble was so much that people were killing their children because they have to eat. The famine was so great. The situation was so terrible. The situation was so horrible. It was not a favorable circumstances. People were eating their children. But suddenly, God sent a word through his prophet, and the word changed the circumstances. When God sent his word, the changing situation must happen. And the prophet said, by this time, tomorrow, listen to me, God is saying to somebody, I'm enforcing the same scriptural revelation that it doesn't matter how long you have been in that situation, by this time tomorrow, things must change for better. The prophet declared the counsel of the Lord that two measures of barley will be sold for a shekel. That means for their scarcity, there will be surplus. By the word of God, the oath of scarcity was broken. Famine was discontinued because God said so. By this time tomorrow, it looks impossible. But when God speaks, he speaks from his capacity to perform. Come on now. When God speaks, he speaks from his capacity to perform. Therefore, I speak to you that the word of God that will turn your circumstances around will come your direction in the precious name of Jesus. By this time tomorrow, you are getting a new job. By this time tomorrow, your famine is over. By this time tomorrow, you are getting a promotion. By this time tomorrow, what has cost you tears, weeping, will no longer be there. For weeping may endure for a night, but certainly joy comes in the morning. Somebody's morning of joy is just coming in right now. In the name of Jesus. Glory, glory, glory be to God. Now let me share something else with you. Right from this scripture, as I'm still talking on Make a Move, I saw number two insight that your reception of God's word will determine your position in the manifestation. Your reception of God's word is what will determine your position in the time of manifestation. Listen to me. The word you don't receive will not release you, neither will it release to you. In verse 2 of the scripture, the Bible says, a Lord on whose hand the king leaned answered the man of God and said, even if God opens window in heaven, can these things be? So the man knew that there could be windows open. But he never received the word to provoke a change in his circumstances. And therefore the prophet said, you shall see with your eye, but you will not eat of it. That was exactly what happened to him. When you don't receive God's word as God's word, it does not change your world. Your reception of God's word is what determines your position in the manifestation. This man will have enjoyed this manifestation because when God speaks, he doesn't need your permission to speak. He speaks from his capacity. He speaks from his side. He speaks from the way he sees things and based on what he can do. But the way you receive it determines what you receive from it. This man, when the word came, probably because he had spent a long time in the problem. You know, many times when you have spent a long time in the problem, every part of your body becomes adjusted to the problem. That can anything still happen? But the prophet said, this is what the Lord said. I want to challenge you. When God speaks, receive it as God's word. Because when you receive God's word as God's word, it settles you. It changes circumstances. There are two ways you can receive God's word. Number one is either you receive it with faith. And when you receive God's word with faith, you are positioned to enjoy full manifestation. You can either receive God's word with faith or you receive it with doubt and unbelief. When you receive it with faith, you enjoy full manifestation. But when you receive God's word with doubt and unbelief, then you will shut down the flow of the releases. This man could not step into the reality of the prophecy because he doubted God's word. Hear me? Hebrews chapter 4 verse 2. The Bible says the word did not profit them anything because it did not mix with faith in them that heard it. Every of God's word that does not mix with faith in you will not be able to deliver you profitably. God's word is profitable, but until you mix it with faith, receive it as God's word, then you enjoy the profit therein. From today, everywhere you have been missing the profit embedded in God's word, I pray for a reversal, a restoration in the precious name of Jesus. And finally, number three thing I saw from this text I want to share with you is that when God speaks, he has his ways of bringing whatever he says to pass. When God speaks, he has his own way of bringing whatever he says to pass. I saw from the scripture that God is not just a God that speaks. He's also a God that performs. And every time he speaks, he has his ways of bringing the word to pass. Right from the scripture, in verse 6 to 7, God already had a program, a strategy to bring his word to pass, because it looks highly impossible for man. But because God said so, look at what happened. The Lord had made the host of the Syrians to hear noise of chariots. They heard noises. They never knew where the noise was coming from, but they were hearing noises. The Bible says they fled for their lives. They left all their resources. They left their gold, their silver, their food. They left it because they were hearing noises. God orchestrated what I call a divine strategy. Come on now. A divine strategy to weaken the base of the enemy because he wants to promote his people. Somebody is listening to me. There is a strategy God is about to put in place for you, because you must get to your place of testimony. God had spoken, but whenever he speaks, he has his ways. He knows what to do to bring whatever he has said to pass. I want to challenge you today to believe what God has said. When you believe whatever God has said, you enjoy whatever he has said, because what you don't believe, you don't become. It is what you believe that you become. I want to challenge you to believe God. Trust God with your heart. Believe him when he speaks, because he speaks from his capacity to perform. What has God told you? What prophecy has gone ahead of you? Your unbelief, your doubt, your lack of faith might hinder your manifestation in the reality. The Lord bless you in the precious name of Jesus. When God speaks, he knows what to do. He caused the adversary to hear strange noise. I'm praying for you in this season that God will step down on your behalf. Cause your adversary, opposition, to hear strange noises. What you need as a possession to come out from the stagnation, they will release it to you in the precious name of Jesus. Glory be to God. Thank you, blessed Father. Now, I'm still going to continue in this teaching. But right before I continue with this teaching, I want to take time out to appreciate every of our TV broadcast partners. I want to thank you for your gift. It has been of great support to us as we advance the kingdom of God and as we reach out to lives in their various places. Thank you so much. I appreciate you for your support, your commitment, as well as your gift that you've been sending in to support and to advance the kingdom of God. I also want to extend the invitation to you. Everyone watching me, wherever you are watching me right now, I want to extend this invitation to you to be a part of our TV broadcast partner as we spread the message of the kingdom of God, impacting lives and empowering destinies all around the clock. The information is on the screen. For any commitment, a monthly commitment of any amount you can afford, maybe $50, $100, $200, whatever you can afford, as we advance the kingdom of God, it will highly be appreciated. You can call the number on the screen or follow the instruction. And for doing this, I will send you a 4-pack audio CD message that is entitled Discerning and Defeating Satanic Strategy. I will send it to you for supporting this work, for advancing the kingdom of God. You will get that. And I know that in the name of Jesus, as we reach out to the people, as we reach out to the world, lives will not remain the same. And you also will not miss your blessing in the precious name of Jesus. Call in right now. Call the number on the screen. Go to the website. Call in. We desire it, and we are praying for you. You shall surely have a testimony in the precious name of Jesus. Glory, glory, glory be to God. Now, right before I came into that realm, I was sharing with you that you need to make a move. Because when you don't make a move, nothing moves. Now, from the text we are looking at, 2 Kings chapter 7, let me share with you the fourth insight. The fourth insight I saw here is that it takes making a move in the direction of God's word to change your world. It takes making a move in the direction of God's word to change your world. The word has been released. The prophecy has gone out. God has spoken by this time tomorrow. But there is a need for relevant moves to be made. Because if you would enjoy relevant results in life, you got to make relevant moves. I saw from the text in 2 Kings chapter 7, verse 3 to 5, the lepers, there were four leprous men. They were leprous men, but even in their leprosy, they made a move. They made a move. I saw something here that even though God had spoken, there is a need for them to make a move, because when you make a move in the direction of God's word, your word does not remain the same. Look at what happened. In verse 5, the Bible says, and they rose up in the twilight. In the twilight, they rose up. Now look at verse 7. Bible says, the enemy, they arose and fled in the twilight. So while the leprous men were moving, God was making the enemy the same hour. So the same moment they made a move, God moved on their behalf. Come on now. When you don't move, God may not move on your behalf. The Bible says, and the tweet light, they moved. The same tweet light, the enemy were hearing strange noises. The adversary were hearing strange noises. That eroded the change of circumstances. I'm telling somebody, God is only waiting for you to make a move. Somebody is waiting for God to move, and God's saying, I'm waiting for you to move. There is a move for you to make. There is an action for you to take. When you take that action, discover what you need to do. Discover the move to make, and things will move in your direction. Though these leprous men had some limitations, yet they dared to move. I saw that they had societal limitation. They were not accepted in the society because when you have leprosy, you don't live within the city. You are an outcast. They had physical limitation, they had leprosy, everything was not okay. But yet in their limitation, they broke their limitation. They step into their harvest, they step into the reality of the prophecy because they made a move. They look beyond their societal limitation. Maybe all you are saying is that the society is not friendly. It's because I don't have an helper. It's because I don't do it. No, make a move. Find what you need to do. Make a move. Break your limitation, even in the move. Enough is of the procrastination. When you procrastinate, you don't experience progress. Deal with excuses. They had all reason to have an excuse. Oh, nobody will accept us. Oh, we have leprosy. But they broke away from their excuses. They subdued their excuses and stepped into their excesses. Come on now. They subdued their excuses and stepped into the harvest. Somebody is stepping into the harvest in this season in the precious name of Jesus. I challenge you to make a move. Find something you need to do. If you have to go to school, go to school. What have you been postponing? What have you been procrastinating concerning? Make a move in that direction. Because when you make a move, things will move in your direction. God bless you. I pray for you today that may God open your eyes to know what to do. Make moves in the direction of God's word. In the precious name of Jesus, God is speaking to somebody. Start that business. You have been postponing it. Start now. Go and start because God has commissioned you to begin. Go to that school. You have the mind to go there. Go right now. You've been there once. You came back. Go back there. Make a move because you will surely get there. You will succeed. You will not fail. In the name of Jesus, God bless you. In the precious name of Jesus. I'm going to continue in the series of this teaching in my next broadcast, and I know you don't want to miss that. You don't want to miss that. Tell somebody about this, and it will be a great blessing to you in the precious name of Jesus. Now, to listen to more of revelational insight and prophetic prayers all around the clock, you can visit our 24 hours online radio on www.prayingradio.org. The information is on the screen. You'll be blessed as you listen to life transforming messages. I can tell you your testimony will abound as you listen in the precious name of Jesus. Thank you once more for tuning into this broadcast. Tell somebody about it. And I want to see you at the Empowerment Center this Sunday, on Thursday, any of our services. You are blessed. Call the number on the screen right now for prayers, for more information. It is well with you. God bless you. Enjoy the peace of God. It is well with your children. Be healed in Jesus' name. Thank you, my Father. Till I come your way again next time, stay empowered and keep empowering others. God bless you. Amen.
Thank you for joining us. Watch us every week at the same time for your moment of empowerment. Visit us online at wordrevival.org or call us at 972-639-1762 or stop by and see us at 838 Secretary Drive, Arlington, Texas.